so hot today.
I know. Let's turn on the aircon.
No, don't do that. Think about the polar bears.
Polar bears? What do you mean? They've got nothing to do with the aircon.
Oh, yes it does.
I think we should investigate.
We've researched how climate change is affecting polar bears.
Burning fossil fuels to get energy is a cause of climate change. This energy is transported to your home every time you flick a switch.
Fossil fuels are formed by decayed plants and animals which have decomposed for millions of years.
The most common fossil fuels are coal, oil, and natural gas.
But when you burn fossil fuels, they release greenhouse gases, most of it being carbon dioxide, which then go up into our atmosphere and creates a layer around the Earth that traps in the heat, causing it to get much hotter.
In this experiment, we have two jars with thermometers inside.
This jar has a layer of plastic wrap representing the carbon dioxide in our atmosphere. We place the jars under a lamp for 1 hour.
Carbon dioxide doesn't hold heat exactly the same way as plastic wrap, but this method shows consistent results.
The jar with plastic wrap retains its heat and stays hotter for longer. 1 hour after we removed the lamp, the temperature of the jar with the plastic wrap is hotter than the one without.
Polar bears live here in the Arctic Ocean, which is a large ocean made up of ice.
Polar bears need the cold because they have adapted to these conditions and have a thick layer of warm, insulating blubber.
They also have 2 layers of fur.
But living here is not all fun and games. Polar bears are in grave danger due to the melting of dens, accessing seals for food, and diseases spreading faster due to heat.
So when you want to call it your place, you're making it hotter than mine. I need my ice baby.
We asked Professor Damon Henry on why we see more effects of climate change in the Arctic.
We learned that the Arctic is covered in snow, and snow acts like a mirror, reflecting most of its solar radiation back into space.
Climate change melts the snow, and this results in darker coverings on the lands and oceans.
This makes the Earth heat up, which is called the albedo effect.
To demonstrate the albedo effect, we covered 2 beakers filled with water with different coloured cardboards.
One is dark blue to represent the ocean, and one is white like the ice.
We shone light on the beakers to see which one heated up the fastest.
There are many ways to help our polar bears and to put an end to climate change.
Like catching more public transport, buying local produce, and recycling more things. Walking or riding your bike more instead of driving in your car. Using more sustainable energy sources instead of burning fossil fuels.
We need our ice baby.